Hello friends, in this video we'll talk about a browser extension known as Chropath, which we use for finding Xpath and CSS locators for automation. So first of all, we go to Google and search for Chropath for Firefox. This extension is also available for Chrome, but we'll first download it for Firefox and see how it works. So this is my sample website, which has various controls like a text box where I can enter a text. It also has a drop down list from where I can select something. It has radio buttons from which we can select only one. It has some checkboxes which allow multiple selection and a button. Now first of all, we'll check the HTML for all these elements and then we'll see how it finds XPath and CSS selectors. So I open developer tools using F12 and using this inspector, I take it to any of the element on the page and it will display me that this is the HTML code written for this object. Okay, so this is how we locate objects. But here we have not seen any role of Chropath. Now we go to Chropath and we click on inspect and we move our mouse pointer. We move our mouse to that element. And you see, as you move your mouse over there, you will get three options. One is your absolute XPath, second is your relative XPath, and third is your CSS selectors. And in most of the cases, it gives you a good XPath which you can directly use in your automation scripts. An important feature also need to be seen here is you see that there is an option where you can test your XPath and CSS. So if I try, let's say /dev, it selects all the divs on the page. It highlights all the combinations and it shows that it found 84 such matching nodes. Also, if you search for a correct XPath, you can see that it should be uniquely present on the page. So it is a very useful utility where you can test your locators whether these are correct or not. So now if we see how to select a locator, or how to find a locator for drop-down list, you see that it correctly find for the list elements also. And if we highlight also, you see that it found one match for this also. And if you also manually verify option @value equals 1830, yes, so it is correct. So now after this list option, you can see that we have radio button and checkboxes present. So for radio button, if we try to find out locator for this radio button, so we get the absolute XPath as well as the relative XPath. So this also we can verify here in the selectors option and it should give us one matching node. Same it works for checkboxes and buttons. So for all the controls we have seen that it gives us very good XPath and CSS selectors and we can directly use these in our automation scripts. So far we have seen it in Firefox browser. So next we'll talk about Chrome. So once we download it, you see it is not present here on the top, but on the right side you will find the extension. So again, similar way, now in the Chropath you do not have selector option, the inspect option, but you need to use the default inspect element of the developer tools and you will directly see the XPath, relative as well as the absolute and the CSS selectors. So the same extension work and exactly in the same way in Chrome also. If I now work on a use case where we have frames on the page, so some of the plugins do not work on frames, right? And you cannot directly search for locators on frames. So here you can see that this button is present on a frame. Now if we use Chropath for finding elements on frame, we can simply see that it gives us its correct relative and absolute XPath as well as CSS selectors. So that's all about Chropath. Let's see what Sanjay say about extreme automation.
Hi friends, I'm Sanjay Kumar. Kamal gave a nice explanation on autonomic Chropath. Subscribe to his channel and learn a lot of stuff about automation. Thank you.